suffering is a unique lesson that we have to learn in our lives, my dear friends. Today in the Gospel, we find James and John. They come to Jesus and they ask for a seat either side of his throne. But then, they never knew his throne in this world is a different kind of a throne. His throne was the cross. His crown was with thorns. And his kingly ring is suffering. And they never knew about it. So starting with the miracles and every glorious activities that they saw with Jesus, now they are heading towards the cross. So Jesus isolates them from the crowd. So in the show, there are many distractions. But from the show, we have to launch with the deep for a personal, profound teaching. That's exactly when they were on the road going to Jerusalem and Jesus was walking ahead. The 12 were anxious and those who were followed were afraid. Once more, Jesus took the 12 aside to tell them what was to happen to him. So, he's teaching them, he's beginning to teach them the suffering. This is after the rich young man coming to Jesus and Jesus asked him to leave everything and follow him. Then he said, how difficult for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. That's the background for this incident. So they were taken aside for a special teaching. What was lacking in the rich young man, to letting go the suffering part, to fulfilling the law. The Old Testament, if you read Sirach 36, today's first reading, how the Lord will bless. All the relationship was based on blessings, prosperity, good health, long life, children, generation. And all these things were considered as the blessings of the Lord. So they measured their life, they measured their love of God with the blessings of the Lord. But then, the Lord was taking them deeper. They all wanted Jesus to be the king, isn't it? Messiah, who redeems them from the Roman Empire. That's exactly why James and John wanted them to be at either side of the throne. When he's going to be the king of all the universe, in their understanding, my dear friends. So Jesus was laughing. Although Jesus taught them, once more Jesus took them 12 aside to tell them what happened to him, what was to happen to him. You see, we are going up to Jerusalem and the Son of Man will be given over to the chief priests and the teachers of the law. They will condemn him to death and hand him over to the foreigners who will make fun of him, spit on him, scourge him and kill him by 3 days later. He will rise. So handing over to the Gentiles means, pagans means, it is the lowest form of curse. It is a kind of a terrible kind of curse. So they could not understand this. However much Jesus taught them, they could not believe this. They were still loafing about. They were just still floating on a mirage, on a place where they imagined to be. They thought, they presumed, they assumed that Jesus is going to be the king in their own understanding. But then Jesus teached them. He wanted to teach them the true journey of the Messiah. And ourselves also. That's why he says, grant us to sit on the, when they say, to grant us to sit one at your right and one at your left. When you come in your glory. But Jesus said to them, you don't know. What are you asking? Can you drink the cup that I drink? Or baptize in the way I'm baptized? Of course, they are the son of Zebedee. They are son of sons of Zebedee. Zebedee has servants, if you can remember. So he's a recognized rich man. So maybe those positions. And also whatever, they thought they are more qualified than the others. Because all the others were angry with them. And Jesus is saying, are you ready to drink from the cup that I'm going to drink? They say yes, but then they don't know what is the cup. What he meant, they never understood until the descendant of the Holy Spirit. With the Holy Spirit only, they realized the meaning of suffering. They could bear that pain. Because without that connection, without you relating to Jesus, without that strength from within, you won't be able to take this cup and drink from it. That's why Jesus was teaching. Although Jesus was teaching, they had never grasped the truth of it, exact total meaning of it. That's why Jesus is saying. But Jesus said to them, you don't know what you're asking. Can you drink the cup that I drink? The cup that I drink, you will drink. And you will be baptized in the way that I am baptized. They are going to suffer. Of course, James is the first smarter disciple. And John is the one who is only disciple who was not killed, who died in his old age. So his pain was to live a life of truth. He had to undergo a lot of pain because he stood by the truth. So there are two kinds of suffering. One is persecution. When you have to live according to the word of God, you have been persecuted many a times, psychologically, mentally sometimes. So that's how John suffered. But then he, on hearing this, the other 10 were angry with James and John. It shows that they never understood it. That's why they're angry. They will be really happy if they really know what is going to be the right and the left side of Jesus' throne. They could have really been happy, but then they all were angry because they were fighting greedily for the position. They were still in the flesh, still in the world. That's why Jesus had to make them wait in Jerusalem. Then he says, Jesus then called them to himself and said, this is a beautiful posture, I said it. Jesus called them closer to him to teach them again. So the moment you go away, you want to find a place in the world. The moment you go away, your self-esteem would come up, your pride, your insecurities would come up. So Jesus, the best answer for that, to get them closer. The moment they get them closer, as you know, the so-called rulers of the nations behave like tyrants. And those in authority oppresses the people. But it shall not so among you. Whoever would be great among you must be your servant. Whoever would be first among you shall make himself slave of all. Think of the Son of Man, who has not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life to redeem many. And this is the exact meaning of our life journey, my dear friends. So as long as we are far away from Jesus, we would search the worldly pleasures, worldly comforts, worldly securities, worldly affirmations, worldly credit. That's why Jesus had to take them closer. Let's go to him again. Go to him again. Be with him. Learn from him how to suffer. With love, you'll be able to bear whatever the pain that you ought to bear. So stay close to him. Stay connected. Ask for the strength to bear the pain that you are given. Amen. May God bless you.